Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for January 9th, 2023. Well, my goodness, on Friday, we took relatively bad economic data, but we had a little bit of hope in there that inflation was decreasing, and that inspired those bulls to get going. And as I'd been mentioning all week, if we pop this resistance to the upside, look for a short squeeze. And that is exactly what we achieved here on Friday. So what does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in? Let's buckle up. Let's get ready for the Monday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. Good morning once again, everyone, and thanks so much for being here. I hope you had a wonderful weekend and you're ready for another wild week in the market. Let's take a look at these charts and see if we can figure out how we might want to approach the market for today. First off, I had been mentioning this chop zone here for quite some time and talking about the fact that, well, either if the bulls found inspiration and we pop through to look for a short squeeze, and if they were to break down through this low to look for some significant selling. Well, we got the bullish side of that and we pushed on up. So now we're trying to push on up here this morning with a little pre-market pump up, but we do want to consider the fact that we're pushing right into this really significant resistance level in the chart. The question will be, can we push on through there, or is there a possibility that we could pop into this resistance and then pull back and get that classic pop and drop? Now, we'll want to watch that closely. If those bulls can maintain that inspiration, then we might push even a little bit higher here in that chart. But once again, I want you to consider this massive resistance that we have up here, and whether or not we can break through that will be the question. Now, if those bears were to be inspired today, well, then I would look for a pullback, and that pullback could come back into here, maybe test that level of price support. And if that were to fail, then we drop back into our chop zone. So kind of keep a close eye on that. I can't tell you what's going to happen today. I certainly don't have a crystal ball, but looking at this chart, we do have that bullish notion here in the chart, with the Dow being the only index able to hold its downtrend as support. And it is also the only index back above its 50-day moving average, or holding above that 50-day. So that'll be an interesting challenge here. Notice we've got quite an accumulation here of those moving averages. So we'll want to watch that closely. If they can continue to hold that as support, then we may have some upside potential. If they were to fail, however, if they were to push this lower, well, just kind of keep in mind all those moving averages then create some resistance in the chart. Now, unfortunately, when we look at our other indexes, we don't have as bullish a picture to be looking at. Taking a look at the SPY here, if you notice, we did break that resistance. We did trigger that short squeeze here to the upside. But you'll want to notice we're going to smack ourselves this morning into a pretty substantial resistance area in the chart. And unfortunately, we still are living in a bear market trend here overall in the SPY. So we'll want to keep an eye on that. Now, having said that, we do want to recognize that we broke this upside trend, but perhaps we can maybe begin some kind of upside trend from this point. So kind of keep an eye on that. We've got this wedging pattern in here. And unfortunately, when we look at our moving averages in the chart, well, there's nothing bullish here, as you can see on this chart. We're pushing up to test that 50-day moving average, and we've got significant moving average resistance above, along with that price action resistance. So keep a close eye on that. We cannot rule out that possibility of the pop and drop. So be careful rushing in with that fear of missing out today. Remember, there's a lot of uncertainty in this market. Worries of recession, worries about how this next earnings season will turn out. So kind of keep that in mind. Let's take a look at our QQQ. Now, we've got to say the same here for the QQQ. We had a nice little bounce in here. And the good news that we have here in the Qs is that we held this price support. So we've tested this area several times and we bounced. But unfortunately, well, we really didn't correct anything here yet. Notice that we're pressing into this next resistance level of the chart. Nothing bullish about that, particularly except trying to bottom. And as you can see, we're still within our bearish downtrend here in the chart, and we have massive levels of resistance above. Notice right in here, we're gonna run into, we're gonna run into those lows. If we push through that, we've got these lows to deal with over here in the chart. If we go a little bit higher, we have these points to watch for, and this significant resistance right here in the chart. So a lot of work here on the NASDAQ yet to do. And if we take a look at our moving averages, well, we're still well below our 50-day moving average with a 34 EMA and a 20 moving average, also providing a lid there on that chart. So any follow through here, we'll have to watch, I think, carefully for that potential of the pop and drop. If we take a look at our IWM, now IWM had a pretty good day on Friday. It tends to move a lot with the Dow, but unfortunately we didn't really resolve anything other than breaking that resistance zone. You'll want to keep in mind that we still had the problem in here with the lower lower high followed by the lower low. And if we were to draw this out in the chart, well, we're still running into that problem here of that downtrend. So this rally back is still got some work to do here. So if those bulls were inspired today and we could push a little bit higher, right up into this area is where I would see that we would run into some resistance. If we can push beyond that level, well, maybe up into here, just considering we have an awful lot of resistance. And if those bears were to be inspired, then I'd look for a retest back here in that congestion zones. Well, if we can find some support off the top of that, that would be bullish. But remember, we are still officially in a downtrend here on the short term. This lower low could mean that all we're doing is rallying back to that resistance for that next lower low in the chart. So watch that close. And we also have all of those doggone moving averages above, creating quite a little bit of price resistance in the chart there as well. So we've got some work here to do on our indexes. And although we get this rush of, hey, it's finally going to get bullish, well, be a little bit careful as we approach those resistance levels. There's no reason to believe just yet that we're ready to break out and just rip to the upside, considering that there is all that uncertainty about the earnings that we're just getting ready to head into. Let's take a look at our VIX. Now, the VIX made a pretty good decision here on Friday, making a big move down. And you'll want to notice right in here that if we were to draw a trend right through there, well, we're resting on that trend. And if we can follow through this morning to the upside here in the market, then we might break this support level here in the chart. Now, I still think this is a little bit of a complacency situation here in the market, considering the fact that how negative the economic data has been coming in and the market has been choosing to ignore it, which is fine. It's just, boy, we have really ignored that the U.S. economy is shrinking, and that is going to be a problem in the near future, I think, with that possibility of recession. So we've been kind of ignoring that, and it'll be interesting to watch and see how this plays out. Nice little wedging pattern in here. We got to give it up to the bulls. They did respect this price resistance in the chart. But again, there may be that little bit of hint of complacency here in that chart. So watch carefully. And then if we take a look at that T21-22 indicator, Is pushed up here in the bearish reversal zone. So unfortunately, that short squeeze on Friday, we stretched this out. Now we still have some upside potential, and we're gapping up this morning, at least at the moment. So I'm guessing in that gap up this morning, we're going to be up here pretty much in the high point of the range here on our overbought condition in T2122. And that's another one of those reasons why we should be watching for that potential as we hit those resistance levels for a little pop and drop. Can't say that that's going to occur, just that the possibility does exist. So in this chart, we can see if we've got bullish inspiration here today to continue pushing, we've got some little bit of upside potential here, but we've opened up a very big downside potential if that pop and drop were to occur, or if those bears were to find inspiration here in the market. So let's take a look at our T2108. Now our T2108 had a nice improvement here on Friday, pushing up, and I've got to give lots of kudos here to the bulls. We pushed up here about 53% of the stocks holding above their 40-day moving average, and you'll notice in here we've got a fairly significant level of price resistance coming up here in that chart that we'll want to watch to see whether or not they can push on through there, or if we get those bears and that potential little pop and drop that could come into play, that resistance in the chart. If we take a look at our T2107, also a nice improvement on Friday, pushing up here strongly, and noticing in here that we bounced off of this price support. That is very bullish in this chart, and we've got 45% of the stocks holding above their 200-day moving average. We will want to consider that there is some price resistance up here in this chart, and once again that we have that extension going on here in the market to kind of an overbought situation for the short term. So watch that closely, but the bulls are in control there as well. If we take a look at our T2101, well, we're still struggling here. Even though we had that short squeeze on Friday, we were still a little bit anemic on volume. So watch that closely, and just keeping in mind that if we are in an overbought condition, that could whipsaw here or push back down. I'm not saying that's going to occur, but we'll want to watch for that possibility closely, and just be remembering that there's a lot of uncertainty about these earnings coming moving forward. So we're trying to climb that wall of worry, and sometimes they can just keep on climbing that wall of worry, but sometimes that worry is so much that it immediately pulls back. So just be a little bit careful. And then if we look at our economic calendar for today, well, our economic calendar, we don't have a whole lot to go on here today. We've got 3-month and 6-month bond auctions. Now again, this might continue to help the bulls maintain control, because it's been day after day after day of bad economic data, and all of a sudden we have a day of relief with no bad economic data to deal with. You will want to keep in mind that we do have a Fed speaker here today, and you'll want to consider carefully, we've got a Jerome Powell speech tomorrow morning, so we'll want to pay attention to that. Now we know our Fed has continued to talk very hawkishly, so we'll want to watch that carefully here. I think he's probably going to continue to pound that drum of saying, we're not done yet, folks, pay attention. So watch that closely. But notice, other than that, there's not much in here to move us around on Tuesday. Wednesday, we've got that mortgage applications and petroleum status. On Thursday, we've got our biggest number of the week. Besides Jerome Powell, we're going to be looking at a CPI reading here and jobless claims. We need to start seeing those jobless claims coming up, so watch that close. And then at the end of the week, we've got consumer sentiment and, you know, just a bunch of Fed speak in here this week. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar. Now our earnings calendar is going to start perking up here. We're going to start developing more and more earnings reports here as we move toward the big bank earnings that will begin later on this week. So notable reports for this morning, AYI. And by the way, guys, I want to remind you all that there is a link just below the title of the video that'll take you back to the morning blog, and you're going to want that as we ramp up on these earnings, because there will be no way I can cover them all here in the morning prep. So kind of keep that in mind. So AYI, looks like we've got a little bit of bearishness coming in here this morning after that report. Watch that close. We've got AZZ. AZZ will be reporting today. I see no action in here in the pre-market on it just yet. Consider all of the price resistance in the chart and the overall downtrend in that chart as we wait. We're going to hear from Jefferies this afternoon. Jefferies had a pretty good day last week, really popping up. Let's see if they can follow through on that with their earnings report. Little upside trend going on in here. Very volatile, however. So kind of keep an eye on Jefferies. Then we're going to hear from CMC. If CMC could be an interesting report to be paying attention to, because steel here recently has been moving up. So watch that closely. This will be our first steel reporting this quarter, and we've seen a lot of steel stocks moving higher. So we might get some bullish benefit in here, and you can see we're trying to pop on through. I'm not sure that's the earnings report or just the bullishness of the morning. So watch that close. Breaking through resistance, very bullish chart, and there's a lot of steel stocks out there that are very bullish. We've got PetSmart that's going to report. Now, this has been a pretty rough chart, trying to hold a little bit of a higher low in here, but overall still in a bearish trend. So watch carefully on that report. We've got some cannabis that will be reporting today, and boy, you just can't, I mean, there's not anything bullish about this chart. It's just bear all the way, and makes you wonder how much longer these companies are going to be able to continue on without some kind of reorganization or change. So watch that closely for TLRY. Then let's see, we have last but not least, we've got WD-40. That will be reporting today. So keep an eye on that. One of those home staples that pretty much I think everybody's got a can or two around their house of WD-40. So still in an ugly downtrend. Watch that close. We are trying to make this higher low, however. So watch for that earnings carefully. How about we take a look at a few stocks that could be setting up for today? But before we do that, guys, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that subscribe button on YouTube and also click that bell icon when it pops up, so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you find these videos to be useful or helpful, if you could please do me that favor and click that thumbs up button and leave a brief comment, that helps the channel to continue to grow. I just want to say thank you so much to everyone who does take the time to do that, that takes the time to share this video out on your social media feeds. And thank you so much, a big shout out for those folks who support the channel through the Buy Me a Coffee link. Thank you very, very much. You guys are awesome. Let's take a look at some of these stocks that could be setting up. And please keep in mind, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any securities. As a matter of fact, you need to be doing your own due diligence, be watching very, very carefully, because I suspect we're gonna see lots of whipsaws, lots of overnight reversals as we move into earnings this quarter. So everyone's going to have to plan their risk very, very carefully. Make sure you're following your risk rules. Don't blindly follow anyone else's trade idea. Make sure the trade fits you. Let's take a look at a few stocks that have been looking amazing. Merck continues to move up very, very strong. I'm showing lots and lots of strength in this chart. Now, I don't know that I'd want to chase it here. Maybe a little rest or pullback in that chart is what I'd be looking for, but watch that closely. Really strong here today. A couple of stocks that you might want to keep an eye on because they're in the news this morning and they rallied up here this last week. Take a look at Visa. Visa's catching an upgrade this morning. Now, keeping in mind, there is significant resistance above here in the chart, but if you take a look, if we can break through some of this resistance and hold a higher low, well, hey, maybe we'll be in good shape. Now, I don't know that I would be all that excited about it, just considering the condition of the consumer, whether they're going to continue to spend the way they have, but watch that closely. And MasterCard is another one in the news today, popping up, breaking through downtrend, breaking through some resistance in the chart, showing lots of strength. Again, I don't think I would chase this move. I need a rest or pullback in that chart to maybe catch a trade, but it is worth watching. Now, having talked about those, let's look at other pay systems that aren't in the news today. But if you take a look at a stock like SQ, now SQ is kind of interesting. This is Block, and you can see trying to break up through that downtrend. And this is one I think I probably would want to keep a pretty close eye on. We break up through that downtrend, pop up in there and hold, I'm going to have some interest in that chart. So watch that carefully. If these pay systems are going to rise, if Visa, MasterCard are going to rise, I would suspect stocks like SQ would begin to come up as well. And then you might want to keep an eye on PayPal. That would be another one that would be interesting. If pay systems are coming up, then PayPal might be coming around. And you can see we shot up here in PayPal. We've still got a lot of work to break the downtrend and move on through. But if we're going to start back on the road with consumers just spending like crazy, and so Visa and MasterCard can go higher, well, there'd be no reason why these couldn't go up as well. So watch those close. Other places you might look, boy, I keep mentioning the US dollar. The US dollar showing a little bit more weakness here this morning, pushing down. That's going to continue to improve things in energy. One of the things I've been kind of surprised about is the resilience here in energy. But with China reopening, and there seems to be a lot of excitement about China reopening, despite the unbelievable weakness in their economy right now, we may be seeing demand come back up here in energy. So take a look here in XLE, breaking through this downtrend. If this holds this higher low in here, I'm probably going to be thinking about some long positions in energy to the upside. So watch that carefully here. And you can see that move in a lot of individual stocks like ConocoPhillips, ExxonMobil, CVX, all starting to show those downtrend breaks and those higher lows starting to come into those charts. So keep a close eye on some of those. Other places, I'm going to continue to mention gold, even though I do believe gold needs a little rest or pullback. We continue to stretch up as the dollar weakens. Keep an eye on gold, silver, steel, aluminum, copper. They're all showing bullish signs, along with the miners like Barrick Gold, Newmont Mining. You could look at some of the ETFs like GDX and GDXJ. A lot of those looking very, very bullish in the market. So with that, guys, I'm running short on time. So I want to wish you all a fantastic day. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks so much for watching my videos. I do truly appreciate it. I will see you right back here bright and early Tuesday morning. Have an awesome day.